welcomes you to the following presentation of the NBA.
That's a look from earlier on as the Nets head to the locker room. They're in no mood to let this game get away from them on their home floor. The activity in front of the Brooklyn Museum, not too far from our setting today here at the Barclays Center. Eastern Conference Finals action. Boy, in a 2-0 series thus far, who will take game three? We're going to find out here live on 2K Sports, bringing you the NBA playoffs. With Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. With us tonight, 1990 NBA Dunk Contest finalist, Kenny the Jet Smith. I remember that 90 event. You were terrific. You were skying all over
the
place.
Man, thanks for having me. But how did they give Dominique that? He did the same dunk three times. If you do the same dunk, you're going to get the same score. That doesn't make sense to me. But hey, man, happy to be here.
GA, it's all yours.
Kevin, thanks. Last season, some people called on Joel Embiid to be more aggressive. The process accepted that with humility, saying, I want to be great, and it's only right for people to expect me to drop 35 a night. At the same time, he said, I'm not a selfish player. If the defense double teams me, it's about making the right play. Kevin?
David, he is showing that maturity. Thanks for that report. Kenny, your shot mechanics look polished, even back in college. Some guys take longer to have that thing look smooth and make some sense optically.
Well, it's repetition more than the visual. So the more you, like I actually shot the ball and my left hand stays on too long. So I had a side spin. Didn't have a natural revolution. So Marcus Smart comes to mind, Lonzo Ball, you know, but the repetition will help you.
You know, there are some guys that, you know, some of the great shooters don't have great. I mean, Ray Allen, Kobe.
Yeah.
Kobe shot it with
Larry
a little
size. Larry Bird's form was different.
But, you know, they perfected it.
Now a look at Philadelphia's starting lineup. Harris and Embiid together in the middle. Shake Milton is out there with Simmons. And it's Green in at the small four. And for Brooklyn, you've got Durant. Kyrie Irving is out there with Harden. Then there's Hill. And it's Jordan in at the five spot. A nice shot by Embiid.
And showcasing that overwhelming strength. Embiid is so skilled at finishing over the aggressive defense.
Now here's Durant. And then Durant with the jam.
I'll bet even they didn't think the pick would work that well.
No. And they get the major league dunk out of it, too.
And my question is, where was the help? Someone rotate over and challenge.
And whenever Harris is aggressive like this, I think it's for the best. Because he has that ability to attract contact.
This is his first trip to the line tonight. That's good from Harris. That's also good. So he hits both free throws.
And at the line, it's all about consistency with him. His routine, his stroke, it never wavers.
On the wing, Harris. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. When you look around the league, a lot of great defenders. Kenny, in your view, what makes a great perimeter defender when you think about those moves?
Wow, long arms, the ability to slide your feet and play multiple positions.
So, BG, Kawhi, those are a couple guys, right?
Anthony Davis. Yeah, guys who are really going to be able to move around and feel comfortable being uncomfortable.
And I would say that I think MPG is a terrific defender. He's an elite-level defender. But the two best are Kawhi and AD because those are the guys that can comfortably guard 1-5. They can guard perimeter and paint consistently.
Great footwork for both.
Yes.
Now here's Simmons. Harden missing his last shot. And Simmons kicks to Milton. Traps in the tray.
And with off-the-charts awareness, Simmons makes plays that others simply don't see.
The pass to Harden. Harden's gone 1 of 3 shooting so far. Harris passes to Simmons. Now here's Green. And here is Harris, covered by Irving from 8. And Harris gets it to go on the assist by Green.
You know, just simple recognition of a size mismatch and going up strong.
Harden the pass to Durant. Pops it up for Jordan. The alley-oop layup, very well done.
The winning mindset of Durant. Unselfish all the way.
Milton kicks to Simmons. Tries to save it, and out of bounds as Brooklyn gains possession. So it's Brooklyn now. Irving surveying the floor. Pass to Harden. Count the bucket, and he's got a free throw coming up as well.
Exceptional play from Harden. He has the poise to turn a bad situation into a good one.
And he's got his first chance at the line here.
One shot.
Throw good, James Harden.
No question, the Beard is as dynamic an offensive talent as you will find.
Passes it to Harris. Kicks it to Green. Shot clock at 5. Harris misses.
That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on him.
And on the way from Irving for 3. And that one is off. And the 76ers go the other way with it. And the foul on Harden. That is his first foul of the game.
The NBA being so much about entertainment, Kenny. If you had to choose the best showman in the league, who would you pick?
Ooh, the best showman.
With style and charisma.
Steph Curry.
Yeah, he'd be right up there, wouldn't he?
LeBron is a showman, but Steph is, I think, the top of the league. Giannis is a showman, but he's by grit, Harden, and maybe someday Zion.
I would go with that as well. The one reason that I have a little concern with Steph is we haven't, those other, like, LeBron doesn't have to have a great team. You know, he can make a team great. That's the one difference with him. I think Giannis can do that.
He made that team great before Kevin Durant got there.
No. Well, he's playing with a few other Hall of Famers. My point is, if you put him out there with guys who weren't all-star caliber players, that's my concern. We've seen, I'm with you, Giannis has done that. LeBron has done that. Steph's a showman in his current existence. And Luka
is an all-time showman.
Now here's Durant. To Harden. The 3. It's hauled in by the 76ers.
Let's give some credit to the defense for how they're guarding this guy right now, because they're refusing to let him get comfortable. Great finish. What a setup. Terrific ball movement there.
And the first timeout called of the game for Brooklyn. Checked in for Brooklyn. Dwight Howard's checked in for Philadelphia. And stolen by Simmons. And officials have been more vigilant, guys, whistling
the travel violations that we see. At the same time, the league revising the rule book to clarify the gather step when players terminate their dribble. Kenny, in that regard, do you like the way the game is being officiated right now?
What is a gather step? Either you're walking or you're not.
Well, it would seem that way, wouldn't it?
Either you're moving or you're stationary.
The gather step's always been there, though. It's just, honestly, a lot of guys didn't have the ability to and didn't know how to master it. Iverson was the first guy that I saw that had mastered the gather step. And that's, to me, it's just kind of the evolution.
Walking in my book. It's
still it's you gather it. You get that extra. It's basically, it gives you a half a step.
I'm old school. Let's walk.
You're old.
Yeah, and you didn't finish school.
You throw good, Milton. Here's Dinwiddie. They need this, and it's good on the layup.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
Hill passes to Howard. He kicks it to Kerr. At the teardrop, second shot opportunity, and there's the nice layup by Howard. And the 76ers lead by six.
And they are attacking the rim and getting great results.
Good work there as it goes.
Well, the multi-time scoring champion Kevin Durant is showing you he has got as complete a game as there is in the NBA. What a pretty pass.
Now here is Harris. Durant with some nice D. Three-pointer. Rebound by the 76ers. Inside. And Griffin sends it back. Second chance effort and gets hacked by the D. He'll go to the line. It's going to be on Blake Griffin. This is his second trip to the free throw line. That's good from Harris.
Kenny, you played alongside some incredible clutch performers. Who would you give the ball to now for a game-deciding three?
Game-deciding three. Steph Curry's number one. Klay Thompson's number two. Ray Allen's retired, so I'll go with Trae Young.
Ooh, what about Dame Lillard?
Dame Lillard, number three. And then Trae.
Steph?
Klay.
Lillard.
Game winning, three, not off the dribble.
I'm going to throw a wild card out there. Kawhi.
No.
Kawhi. Kevin and I saw him hit one of the biggest threes.
Yeah, that's a wild card.
That's a wild card. Hey, he hit a three to get to the final.
Yeah, I'm not mad at that.
And he was injured in that game. Yeah. Those series.
Listen, we know Dwight Howard is on the back nine of his career, but he can still be valuable. This guy is capable of a double-double every night.
Free throw good, Howard. No good on the second free throw.
Just doing the job on the backboard.
And there's the pass to KD. That drops. And it comes off an assist from Griffin. KD's got 7 points. It's to Curry. It's back to Hill. Here's Howard. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. It's going to be on Blake Griffin.
Boy, there is such a punishing physicality to the game of Dwight Howard. Excellent job getting to the free throw line.
76ers have made 6 of their 7 attempts at the line in this one. That free free throw missing.
Yeah, a lot of whistles here early, as well as foul trouble starting to be an issue.
You can't make the second free throw either. Missing both.
And this summer, Vince Carter retiring after his 22nd NBA season. That's a record for longevity in the game. Kenny, he's closer to our age than he is to some of his teammates.
Yeah, that's amazing. A guy could do it at this level so long and really help the team instead of just be on the team. He's an incredible athlete. That dedication and willingness is just rolled over into time.
Never had to be the main guy at this stage of his career, always wanting to supplement, help, tutor, mentor, and he stayed healthy.
Stayed healthy, that's the key.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn.
And team strategies closely guarded. One aspect of the game the fans aren't always privy to.
It's tough to hide your communications. Teams go to great lengths to try to do it, but sometimes to no avail.
The inbound pass, no good off the back of the rim.
Well, that's a blown defensive coverage, but it doesn't matter. He cannot answer the bell.
And he gets the bucket.
Well, we've seen this over the course of George Hill's career. So savvy, finding the open man.
Here's Dinwiddie. The wide open look for Durant. Off target from outside. Dinwiddie against Hill. He dishes it to Harris. It's back to Hill. 76ers moving the ball around. Howard finds Harris, and that comes off the assist by Dwight Howard. Now it's a 6-point Philadelphia lead. Dinwiddie passes to KD. And no good. Some solid defense from Harris. And it's Harris with the ball for the 76ers. They come into this one after losing on Sunday.
I tell you, they were drawing a lot of iron from the perimeter. Couldn't get the threes to go down. And really, the story of the game.
What was most disturbing to me was they didn't have a backup plan, right? The threes aren't falling. What do you do next?
Yeah, still commanding a lot of defensive attention. Howard just keeps his head up and finds the open man.
And Durant launches from deep. That doesn't go either for Durant. Outside Curry. Right side Hill. Passes it to Harris. And slam dunk by Harris.
Yeah, they have gone full throttle from the opening tip, showing no signs of letting up.
Well, you set the tempo early, and when you get command and control of a game, it's perfect.
Here's Griffin, goes to the reverse layup and keeps it in.
And they've come out with a take-no-prisoners approach on the glass here tonight, guys.
Pass to Harris. And the 76ers tack on two more.
I'll tell you, the team is simply riding the hot hand. This guy has been lights out.
KD against Curry. KD looking around. Five to shoot. Tries it from 19, and he comes up with the deuce. Durant's got 9 points.
Nice shot from mid-range. Once Durant gets his feet under him, he's nailing that shot.
A free-flowing first quarter. Great scoring through one. Philadelphia ahead as they end the first quarter with a 13-4 run. And back with the start of the second quarter in just a moment. Naturally a ball-dominant player, James Harden talked to us about others setting him up a little bit more.
Yeah, that's the goal. That's the goal. Of course, playing off the ball is something that I'm comfortable doing. Like, I'm able to catch and shoot. I'm able to play off, you know, on the wings.
Giving their offense another dynamic.
And it also helps him preserve some energy for those big moments in the big game.
Welcome back to Playoff Basketball on 2K Sports. This is the Eastern Conference Final. And looking at what we've seen from the 76ers, what do you guys think?
Well, credit their anticipation skills on the defensive end. They forced a number of turnovers.
And a few of those led to quick scores at the other end. Really active first quarter for them.
Well, you've got Brown. Griffin is out there with Harden. And it's Claxton in at the fourth shot. That's the Nets five as we get into the second quarter.
And a score the likes of James Harden. It seems like he's broken it down to a science.
Yes. Footwork, create space, and be a heck of a shooter.
Did you look at the way you played, Kenny, as science, like we're talking about here with Harden?
Not maybe as easily observed as he is, but I had a game plan. I'm like, I'm going to get it from free throw line to free throw line as fast as I can. That's my first thought. I'm going to, on pick and rolls, get 2 feet in the paint. That's my second. And every inch that you give me at the three-point line, I'm letting it go.
I love that answer.
And it's a great approach. And this guy, he really has mastered the game in terms of just his overall approach to scoring the basketball. And I'll tell you another thing. I've never seen a guy with the degree of difficulty for his complete arsenal. You never see him just get an uncontested layup or catch and shoot three. Everything he has to create.
Now the pass to Harden. Looking to get it going. Whistle blows. Bucket is good. And he'll have a chance at the line to make it a three-point play.
Using that strong frame, using it to his advantage. Harden showing what's up his sleeve.
He's gone 1 of 1 in the game so far from the line. Some changes for Brooklyn. DeAndre Jordan's checked in for Nicholas Claxton. Harris comes in for Bruce Brown. And Irving subbed in for Dinwiddie. Then for the 76ers, Embiid, he's checked in for Howard. Simmons comes in for Tobias Harris. And it's Shake Milton in for Seth Curry. Free throw good, James Harden.
And the way Harden plays the game, incredible. So much energy and really as creative as they come.
Now here's Simmons. Back to Embiid. Simmons trying to get open. A nice shot by Embiid.
And they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing the ball into the paint.
Pass to Irving. Drops in the layup for two. Irving's got his first bucket of the night.
Losing your man defensively when Harden has the ball, that's unforgettable. He's the top-tier creator.
Here's Maxey. Lays it up off the glass. And the 76ers lead by 10.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
And that's typical of this guy. He's always reading the situation, reacting quickly, and capitalizing.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
Kenny, so much can happen on draft night. What was it like for you the night you were selected out of North Carolina, number 6 overall?
It was interesting because I wasn't sure if I was going to Sacramento.
Really?
Because I interviewed for everyone else in the top 10, basically, except for them. And they took me without an interview. And that surprised me. Not very often, Greg, in life you get a job without an interview.
Yeah.
Well, I got that.
A high-paying job.
A high-paying one at that.
No less.
That misses, so he splits the free throws.
Well, how about the 2008 NBA draft? DeAndre Jordan becomes the 35th pick and becomes an All-Star for the first time in 2017. Boy, really an example of what can happen when you put the work in.
And a bit of a battle here for the ball. The official signals a jump ball here. Defense doesn't get much better than the mobile one block we just saw on replay.
And bringing that postseason intensity, so key. These plays can change the trajectory of a game.
And here are the the 76ers now. Four on the clock. Simmons passes to Maxey. And it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession here.
76ers ball.
Just under 3.5 minutes played here in the second quarter. And the wide open shot from Green. And again, it's Philadelphia.
Pick works well there. Not much resistance from the D.
It takes incredible effort to stay connected to the hip of the offensive player. You've got to want to work.
And that one's good, Maxey.
And Simmons is just the total package. I mean, a player that can really dish it to his teammate.
Now, here is Harden, defended by Milton. Harden kicks to Irving. And again, no good by Brooklyn.
They have been board dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in crafting this huge lead. Love seeing a point guard who can explode to the rim like that.
Oh, great attitude and even a better finish.
Boy, it's incredible how much explosive scoring ability can come from the lead guard position. That is a big-time play.
Maybe the best ever at earning free throws. I mean, Harden has mastered the art of contact and still being able to get off the shot.
The Nets have shot 75% at the line tonight, going 3 for 4.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
Free throw drops for Harden.
Yeah, in this quarter, they've had the right approach, driving and drawing, initiating contact, create opportunities, get to the line.
Harden hits them both. Now, here's Maxey. 6 points for him. Passes it to Embiid. Over Jordan. And he can't bank that one in. Nets trail by 13. Kicks it out to Harden. Shot's good. Griffin making the play. Harden's got 12 points in the game.
So many plays have run through Harden. You like to work him off the ball. Give the defense a different look.
Brooklyn with the rebound. Jordan's got 4 rebounds in this game. Here's Griffin, and the slam by Blake Griffin.
And how about that? What a sensational finish.
Hey, you got to be able to get some hang time to do that one. Simmons passes to Milton. It's good from long range. He's got 11.
Well, the defense daring him to shoot, and he makes them pay for their disrespect.
Timeout called the Nets.
Yeah, I think Coach calls his timeout right now because he's not happy with the distribution of shots. Difficult shots, contested shots. You've got to get a better offensive rhythm.
Brooklyn making a change here. Durant's checked in. And the 76ers also making a change. George Hill's checked in for Maxey. Irving dishes to Jordan. Kicks it to Harden. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Jordan. Harden's got 15.
Well, they're not behind because of this guy. He is putting on a tremendous run.
Pass to Hill. To Simmons. And Simmons slams it in.
I'm amazed at Simmons' athletic ability. He moves so fluidly for someone that size.
Harden finds Jordan. And the jam by Kevin Durant.
A power flush with a long hang on the rim at the end of that.
That could be a catalyst for him. It really could. Here's Milton. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. He's got 13.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Can't afford to leave someone uncovered like that. Irving will torture for this mistake.
Philadelphia leading by 9. Hill inside. Covered by Irving. Ben Simmons gets the bucket. Nets have gone 7-13 from the field since the start of the second. The pass to Harden. Here's the 3. Tips it up. And there's Jordan putting it right back in. Jordan's got 5 points now this quarter.
What about the intensity? Go ahead, Mr. Jordan. We see you working out there.
Oh, the lob for the
And how about the connection Simmons has with his guys? Once the lob is on its way, you know he's going to finish and stop.
Harden, no good.
No idea why he's attempting so many outside shots. It's not his day, and he needs to either look to drive or get it to an open teammate.
And Simmons kicks to Green. And the 3 off target. And the foul on Harden. That'll be his second foul of the game. So for the Nets, Bruce Brown comes in for Harris. And Dinwiddie subbed in for James Harden. Philadelphia also making some changes. Tobias Harris comes in for Green. And Curry subbed in for Shake Milton. And Simmons has got the ball here for the 76ers. The biggest lead of the game, 15 points. Hill passes to Harris. Here's Embiid. And the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
And you've got to admire the toughness that Embiid plays with. He doesn't let fouls stop him from scoring.
And this is his first trip to the line tonight. Nicholas Claxton's checked in for Brooklyn. The 76ers also with a sub. Dwight Howard, he's checked in for Ben Simmons.
Really an underrated part of Embiid's game. Excellent as a foul shooter for a 7-footer, so you just can't hack away at it.
Now, here is Irving. And a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot 2 here.
No question, he got bumped on that shot.
The Nets have hit most of their free throws tonight, 5 of 6.
Kevin Durant at the line for 2.
Take a break, take a break. 2 shots.
The free throw drops for Durant.
And they haven't let points get away from them at the line tonight. That's always something that'll allow a coaching staff to breathe a little easier.
Durant hits them both.
And it's been a really good day for him at the line. Some other bigs have well-documented problems on their free throws. He's not one of them.
Now here's Embiid. He has 7. And they double up Embiid. Here's Howard. That one goes in for him, too, making it look easy. He's now 4 for 4.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
Irving passes to Durant. Shoots over Embiid. They grab their own miss. Claxton, his shot is good, making him a perfect 2 for 2 from the floor.
This guy is just working his tail off on the boards. You love the effort, love the energy.
Howard with it, guarded now by Irving. And that one drops. Howard's got 11.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Pass to Durant. Good, and the assist goes to Irving. Irving's got his 4th assist with that last one here tonight.
Well, listen, you do the best you can to make Kevin Durant take tough shots, but this guy, lightning quick release, unbelievable shooter, so hard to guard him.
They're getting on a roll inside. Their last 3 field goals have come from the paint.
The 76ers have shot 70% from the free throw line tonight, 7 for 10. That's good from Harris.
and he just seemed to have a little more fire in the first quarter than he has in this one. And it showed in all the trips he made to the free throw line. Those have dried up.
Now here's Durant, 15 points in the game. And then Durant with the dunk.
Nice. When you run screen and roll, you give the defense a lot to account for, especially when you're running it with KD.
Pass to Embiid. Six on the shot clock. Here's Curry. It's deflected.
Hope they get it back.
And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. And what about our special guest? Kenny, thanks for taking the time to join us, dropping by. Always a pleasure. You add so much to the broadcast.
Man, thanks for having me. This is just great.
Thank you. What a pleasure it was to have Kenny joining us. Outdoors, he's been in the business for a long, long time.
Boy, as great as Kenny Smith was on the basketball court, he was a tremendous guard, a championship guard. He's been equally impressive off of it. This guy's a mainstay in the studio, Emmy Award winner, truly a special treat.
First trip to the free throw line for him in this one.
Two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
The first one falls. And so he hits both. And the 76ers decide to take their first time out here. Left in the second quarter. Hill kicks to Embiid. Hill passes to Howard. Embiid wide open. They get it again. That one goes. Count it. Howard's got 6 points in the quarter.
It's a plus five advantage for them in rebounding after that one.
Pass to KD. The 17-footer. He squares up and sinks it. KD's got 19 points.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
Hill against Irving. There's the pass to Curry. Six to shoot. I'm deep. And there's the foul. It'll go on Bruce Brown. That's his first foul. And here's Maxey. He's got six. Basket counts. Embiid's got 9 points.
Offensively, we see Embiid all over the floor. But inside is where he can really utilize that size.
And so it's Philadelphia looking at a 13-point lead heading into the next quarter. They've been putting on a clinic in the paint. Shots are falling with regularity, and they are pounding it down low. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Kevin, thanks. Joel, the reserves have been a big story. What are you seeing from them?
The bench has helped us a lot. They've come in, they've scored the ball, they've gotten stopped, so we're going to need them to keep it going.
We'll see if they can close it out in the second half. Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, everybody. You've been watching the Eastern Conference Finals on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson, Kenny Smith, and Shaquille O'Neal. Checking out the 76ers. They need this game, and it sure looks like they're going to get it with the awesome display they're putting up right now. There were people already saying their postseason was finished, but a win here in Game 3, and this is a whole new series. Let's start with you, Shaq. What'd you think about the 76ers?
The difference to me has been their offense in the paint. When they've had a mismatch, they take full advantage. They're making smart entry passes, not trying to force the ball when the opening is not there.
Kenny, what's your take on Brooklyn so far?
Well, after the field goal percentage they allowed in the first half, it's time for them to get tough. That's right, tough. If they're going to stay in this game, they'll need to turn this into a street fight. Get physical. Let some elbows go. Yes, let them go. And guys know there are going to be no more easy baskets in here. Let them know that.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final.
Horn. Oh, buzzer.
Back with you, all set to bring you more action from Game 3. What a game we're seeing from Kevin Durant.
With so much on the line tonight, you have to be impressed with the way he came out and set the tone with his aggression.
You get the sense when there's big-time performances to be had, this guy wants to take part. You expect that this is a trend that will continue here.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Third quarter action getting rolling right now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Here's who's on the floor. And so in the game for the 76ers, Harris and Embiid together in the middle. Simmons is out there with Shake Milton, and it's Green in at the three slot.
And that bucket adds to what has been a big difference in points in the paint between the two teams.
And the foul called on Danny Green. That is his first foul of the game. Let's take another look at the staunch defense during that mobile one block.
And you've got to take your defense up a notch in the playoffs. He takes it up about three notches on that block.
Simmons against Irving. High post shot. And DeAndre Jordan throws it down.
If you don't do your work early and push DeAndre Jordan a little bit out of his comfort range, look out.
Simmons working around. Harris passes to Green. Some nice ball movement here by the 76ers. Just five to shoot. Tries from seven. And Simmons with the nice bucket inside. Simmons got 12 in the game. Irving kicks to KD. And finished off by KD.
A natural born scorer is Kevin Durant. He puts in the time and it pays dividends on the floor.
Here's Harris. And it goes down 2 points. Harris has got 19 points.
They're scoring boatloads of buckets. It's raining buckets from inside.
Pass to Harden. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for one more coming up.
Boy, that's 3 for 4 this half. You like that they're starting with a little bit of extra energy. Nice.
The Nets have gone 9 of 10 from the line, so making the most of their chances. Throw good, James Harden. Philadelphia leading by 12. Simmons the bounce pass. Harris inside. Harris is there. And the basket by Harris. Harris has got 4 this quarter.
Unwilling to let up, even for a moment. That's his killer instinct, just fanning the flame.
One thing I enjoy is watching players who don't pay attention to the score. You lock in on the moment and play the right way.
Now here is Harris following the shot by Kevin Durant. Passes to Milton. Shot clock at 6. Good on the bucket. 11 points for Joel Embiid.
Man, have they been effective at getting the ball inside.
Timeout called, the Nets.
And no doubt, coach wants them to shore up their interior defense.
I think right now they're giving up way too many easy looks. That is a recipe for disaster.
Minutes gone now in the third quarter. Outside, Irving lets it go from deep, and the Nets miss again. And Simmons has got the ball here for the Philadelphia 76ers. 16-point lead, the largest margin in the game.
It's impressive, the level of domination at both ends, and you're seeing the results.
You know this. It's not easy building a lead on the road, but this team has been lights out throughout the game.
For Philadelphia, they've gone as spotless, 6 of 6 from the field since taking the court here in the second half. Simmons passes to Embiid. Over Durant. Embiid, no good. Brooklyn's gotten blank from three-point land so far in the third, still 0-for-3. Harden gets the bucket.
And I love seeing Harden get room to shoot from that mid-range position, an effective scorer in that area.
Here's Simmons, and the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
76ers have shot the ball pretty well from the line, going 8 of 11. Dinwiddie has checked in for Kyrie Irving.
One shot.
That's good from Simmons.
The 2018 Rookie of the Year. Simmons' NBA career got off to a great start, and he's only continued to improve.
Green with the block. Pass to Embiid over Jordan. Embiid, no good.
Yeah, but the hand in the face. It's critical that you contest his shots every time down the floor.
And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Embiid. And the 76ers making a change here. Howard's checked in. Here's Dinwiddie. Simmons with the defensive effort.
And with the success they've had rebounding the basketball, they're right where you'd expect them to be, firmly in the driver's seat.
And that's collected by DeAndre Jordan. Nets trail by 20. KD with it. Guarded by Simmons. Here's Harris. And slam dunk by Harris.
Obviously more of a shooter than a dunker, but Harris showing some verticality to his game.
Now here's Milton. He's guarded closer. And the dunk by Embiid.
Oh, Kev, he put some anger behind that one.
You're telling me. Dinwiddie outside. The pass to Harden. Pops it up for Jordan. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
Well, we've seen this one or two times, have we not? DeAndre Jordan, finishing end of the alley-oop. Nice.
A shot by Milton, no good.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be, because he is so strong in the paint.
is where you want transition opportunities to end.
The Nets have shot 10 of 11 at the line. Nice work so far for them. Griffin's checked in for Brooklyn. Brown comes in for Harris. And then for Philadelphia, Seth Curry, he's checked in for Green. Maxey comes in for Shake Milton. And George Hill's subbed in for Embiid. The free throw drops for Dinwiddie. Here's Simmons. 15 points in the game. Outside Hill. To the wing right side. To the paint. Ben Simmons gets the bucket. Simmons got 7 points here in this quarter.
This guy is cooking right now. He is leading them on the offensive end as they remain in front here.
Harden the pass to Jordan. The Nets working the ball around now. Outside Griffin. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Brown. Kicks it out to Dinwiddie. Griffin dishes to Jordan. Brown outside. Another shot. That one, no good. Curry with the defensive effort. Pass to Maxey. Simmons, the bounce pass. Howard, the pass to Curry. Off target with his three. And here's Griffin. He'll bring it up for Brooklyn. 17-point game. Passes it to Dinwiddie. Down low, and sent back by Howard.
Now Dwight Howard at his best, sending it back.
And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. And it's the 76ers with the ball. The 76ers leading by 17. Hill passes to Simmons. And they double up Simmons. Curry with a wide open look. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got 6 assists now in the game.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
Here's Harden, and it's sent back by Howard. And now here comes Simmons leading the break. Again, Curry missing. Brooklyn's gotten blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0 for 3. Round kicks to Harden. It up for Jordan, and DeAndre Jordan throws it down.
What a find by Griffin. He's a lot more skilled as a passer than he gets credit for. As far as power forwards go, he has terrific vision.
Timeout called, the 76ers.
For viewers, timeout's a chance to check your phone, grab a drink, but for the teams, it's all about business.
Well, there's something that the coach doesn't like. I'm curious to see which kind of adjustment he makes here.
To Maxey. To the middle. The kick out to Hill. And Harden comes to help. Knocks it loose. Curry on the wing. 5 on the clock. The 76ers with another miss.
Well, this is the night you look at your teammates and tap them on the back and say, good job, because for him, he's been struggling all night. Well, after netting one in the first half, that's the second deep ball to go down for this guy.
Back to Curry. The floater.
The DJ twice on the pipes. No, sir. Get it out of here.
Back to Howard. Over Brown. That's good from Howard on the assist by Curry. Howard's got 15 points.
What a great shooting performance. His percentage is outstanding.
Dinwiddie finds Harden. But they recover it. Again, and that'll be 2 free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
As as crafty as they come. Harden uses that tremendous body control to his advantage.
This will make five trips now to the free throw line for him tonight. Free throw drops for Harden. KD's checked in for the Nets. Harden hits them both.
Even though they're down, they are putting on a show at the free throw line.
And the pass to Howard. Curry attacking, and Hill has it in the corner. Philadelphia moving the ball around, and the shot goes down. Howard's got 4 points in the quarter.
And not quite as aggressive from outside as they were in the first half. Sticking to the high percentage shots, playing smart with the lead.
Bucket is good.
Superb at finishing through contact. Harden is just so elusive and creative on those strong drives.
Pass to Maxey. They get it back. Moves back up. And denied. He sends it right off the glass. Harden inside the three-point line. It's good.
And arguably no one in the NBA draws more attention than Harden. Part of why that he creates so many opportunities for others.
Pass to Curry. Good, and it's Hill picking up the assist. Curry's got his second basket of the night.
After being held scoreless in the first, he's turning it on here in the second.
Ball's not loose.
And that's his fourth, and no doubt he would have liked to have not gotten it this soon.
These are his third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
DeAndre Jordan. Two shots.
First one falls for him. And Brooklyn making a change here. Irving's checked in. And the 76ers also making a change. Harris has checked in. And so Jordan nails both of them. Philadelphia leading by 14. Pass to Simmons. To the inside. They double him with Irving. Curry. And he drops in the layup off the glass. Curry's got his third basket of the night right there.
I love it whenever Steph Curry decides to go inside. This guy has the potential to be a dangerous scorer from that area.
Durant with three. Rebound by the 76ers. Howard's got rebound number 11 for him here tonight.
Well, he hasn't proven to be much of a floor spacer for them. He had the 1-3, but that was back in the first half.
Their ability, again, to stretch the floor, particularly in this second half.
And, guys, boy, when you're hitting, it sure does work. It obviously opens up major options at the offensive end.
Well, through three quarters of play, down double digits, it may be difficult to overcome. 76ers lead by 17. Live from Brooklyn, New York, you're watching 2K Sports. And a chance right now to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Well, making the game easy for your teammates. All about putting them in a position to score. That's pretty.
And with the fourth quarter upon us, time is running out for this game to become competitive. We've got Harden. Durant is out there with Joe Harris. And it's Kyrie Irving. And it's Jordan in at the five down low. So that's the lineup for Brooklyn.
Shooting for Brooklyn.
the first one at the line is good. Harden hits them both. Here's Simmons. And there's the pass to Milton. Right wing. Embiid against Jordan. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
And who draws more fouls than Embiid? Very few players, if any. Too much size and really too much skill to defend.
Shooting two.
The first free throw is good. And Embiid drops them both. Here is Harden. Pass to Irving. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. Harden's got 5 assists tonight.
I love that Kyrie Irving doesn't settle for something on the perimeter. He goes right to the cup.
Now here's Green. Passes it to Embiid. Shoots over KD. Just 5 on the clock. Floats one up. And there's the foul on the shot. He'll go to the line for 2. And Brooklyn called for the foul.
And sometimes you have no chance at stopping Simmons from the interior. Just a very skilled player who gets these calls routinely.
First free throw is good.
We're still waiting for that first miss from the line this half.
He doesn't get the second one. And that's trail by 16. Irving finds Jordan. Durant for 3. And Embiid pulls it down. Embiid's got 6 rebounds now in the game. And he makes that one.
Well, just great intelligence there from Danny Green. This guy a pro at knowing when and where to attack the basket.
Now here's Irving. Outside, KD. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. Embiid's got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Simmons inside. He's covered by Irving. 2 points. That one goes.
He's an absolute gym rat. Simmons is relentless in his pursuit to dominate really all phases of the game and improving with his scoring.
Irving's shot is good.
A little artistry in the painted area, converting against the size.
Some guys just relish the challenge. Find a way, and he does.
Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a 3-point play.
They're doing a really good job of getting the ball inside and attacking the paint. That's an area they have completely dominated.
What's up?
That's good from Simmons.
And not a single free throw attempt in that first half, but he has been far more active since the break and drawn some fouls.
Now, here is Harden. And slam dunk by Jordan.
Kyrie Irving doing work with the pass. That's pretty.
Pass to Harris. Now, here's Milton. And it's off from 3-point range. The pass to Harden.
Well, they'll be happy with that look, even though it didn't fall.
I think expect them to go back to it, because that's the kind of shot this offense is designed to generate.
To the middle, here's Durant. Yes, and it's Irving picking up the assist. Irving's got his 7th assist here tonight. Simmons passes to Milton. to the left side wing. Embiid, but he recovers it. Second chance shot. Oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard. Hits it from three-point range. And the 76ers lead by 20.
Well, this guy is a lethal distance shooter. Danny Green lights out.
Pass to Durant. Outside for Jordan. And Embiid pulls it down. Embiid's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. KD against Green. Back to Simmons. Passes it to Embiid. Over Jordan. Again, Embiid missing.
The fadeaway, not a terrible idea, but he needs to make the game easier on himself. He's overcomplicating things.
Just impressed with the teamwork out there, setting the table for one another.
Embiid dishes to Harris. Harris draws the double. Embiid finds Green. Another three for Philadelphia.
Really in a good position thanks to the accuracy from beyond.
Harden surveying the D. Down low. And the rejection by Embiid.
Length plus agility. Great recipe for blocking shots. Embiid's one of the best to do it.
Well, two long range bombs in the first, but that's stalled out right now.
And here's Embiid. He'll bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. A 21-point lead, the biggest in the game.
And that's just cold-blooded right there. He's taking no prisoners.
Well, when it's closing time, he's trying to lock the door. He's been going all night. Well, as usual, this guy cooking on the offensive end. But right now, the other guys on his team have got to step forward.
The 76ers leading by 20. Timeout called, the 76ers.
And he could tell his guys starting to wear down a little bit. Call time to just let them get their legs back under them.
To Milton. Now Simmons. And they double up Simmons to the paint. Here's Embiid.
And if you want to talk about a player who embodies the power game, then Embiid's your man. You know you're going to get some strong finishes anytime he's on the court.
It's Harden with the drive, and he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up. One on Embiid.
You know, I love how he absorbs the foul and still had a chance to knock that one down.
Out of the line for your Nets, James Harden. Taking two shots.
That free throw, no good. Dinwiddie's checked in for Irving. And he's good on the second. Philadelphia leading by 21. Harris outside. He's got it. Green left side. Five to shoot. A pass to Milton. And that one, good.
Well, Danny Green excels at recognizing when his teammates have open looks and putting it on the money. Nicely done.
Now here's Harden, defended by Milton. The three from KD. It's good. The assist that time from Harden. Harden's got his seventh assist in the game. With three, Harris. No good on that one. And Brooklyn will come the other way. Dinwiddie passes to KD. And it's good. 2 points. KD's got 14 points here in the second half.
Well, this is what makes Kevin Durant maybe the greatest all-around scorer in the game today. Equal proficiency from every spot on the floor.
Now here's Simmons. The feed now to Embiid, and they pick up two. Embiid's got 19 points.
And obviously his momentum from the last game has carried over here tonight.
No, I think that's the one thing every player is searching for, consistency. They're giving this guy a chance to carry the offense once again.
Here's Milton following the three-pointer by Brooklyn. Harris inside. KD's on him.
Yeah, the defender all over.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And the first one drops.
Yeah, and their free throw shooting has really improved here in the second half.
Howard's checked in for Joel Embiid. And Harris drops them both. Nets trail by 19. Outside Durant. And a miss there on the triple.
And you know what? If you're the defense, you got him right where you want him. Let him keep shooting those threes because he's been brutal in this half.
Now here's Howard. Here's Milton and blocked. That one goes careening off the glass. Dinwiddie against Harris. Dinwiddie right side. And he overdid it there. Too much force, it looked like, on the foul, and he's called for the flagrant.
Boy, a very hard foul that time, and the officials had to slap him with the flagrant. I mean, you can't let him get away with that kind of contact.
Yeah, gee, that's an easy call for the officials to make when there's that much contact. The league is really cracking down on those sort of plays. And he can't get the first one. Good on the second free throw. Knocked away. Dinwiddie with the bucket.
Yeah, he needs to take a lot more shots. He's been efficient, trying to get his teammates involved, but it's time for him to step up.
Here's Harris. Pass to Howard. And it's Howard finishing it off.
This is a lethal combination of size and skill. Dwight Howard doing work.
Passes to Jordan. And here's Harden. And Harden with the stuff.
Oh, Kevin, not a petty, not a manny, but facial.
Oh, bounce to the ounce, Greg. Yeah, showing off the bunny. Now here's Simmons. And they double up Simmons. Here's Green. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got his ninth assist in the game now.
What an aggressive timeout. Mindset in this period. He's starting to take over.
Now a timeout call by Brooklyn.
And Kevin, he saw his guys just a little sluggish out there. Oftentimes a timeout like this allows you to kind of just reset.
present our New Balance Player of the Game, Tobias Harris.
And his performance has been a jaw dropper. It must have been feeling great coming into the building tonight, because once he hit the court, it was all working for him. He was in a zone.
And Greg, to play like he has under the most intense circumstances here in the playoffs makes it all the more remarkable. Here's Harris. Harden the pass to... Oh! Hammering it in!
Well, Kevin Durant with a little crafty creativity. KD at the rim.
Pass to Harris. Here's Simmons. And again, it's Philadelphia.
And he can be devastating with that little hook shot of his.
Outside Durant. Simmons with it. Defended by Dinwiddie. The pass to Milton. Green with the ball. Clock at six. He kicks it to Howard. Rejected by Harris. And they'll keep possession. Basket good. Green's got 12 points here in the second half.
And now we can start talking about game four. What a magnificent effort and really a significant victory for the 76ers.
It was a standout performance across the board.
I mean, it was like watching a cat play with a mouse. They were able to do more or less whatever they wanted.
And as one might have guessed coming into this game, it was indeed another big game tonight for Tobias Harris.
Boy, whatever was needed, he provided it. He was the jack of all trades. Big bucket on one end, big defensive play on the other. I thought his influence was felt all over the floor.
Durant, good. It's Harden with the assist that time. KD's got 37.
Well, this is what they needed earlier on. At some point, it's too little, too late.
Yeah, but then again, this run came against a team that may have felt it had already won, and you get the sense it let its guard down.
And what patience from Simmons on offense. So skilled at making the D feel nervous when he has the rock.
Taking two shots.
Shooting two.
And he makes the first. A platoon swap here for Brooklyn. And the 76ers will go for a different look here. Anthony Tolliver. He's checked in for Howard. Matisse Thybulle comes in for Green. Korkmaz checked in for Shake Milton. And it's Seth Curry in for Tobias Harris. And Simmons drops them both. 35 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Pass to Griffin. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
And a big man that plays with a lot of versatility in his game. Opponents have to be cautious of Griffin on the drive.
Taking two shots.
And he knocks down the first one.
And there are only a handful of players who can create excitement just by being on the floor. And Griffin is one of them.
Blake Griffin hits them both. There's 25 seconds left in the fourth quarter. And they can just let the clock run out here.
Cannot argue with the W.
Curry is inside. He's guarded by Johnson, and he gets it to go.
Well, they knew it would be a hostile environment, and they rose to the challenge.
And sometimes when everyone's rooting against you, it seems to bring the unit closer together. It certainly did tonight.
So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. Things were looking bleak for him, obviously, coming into this game. But with tonight's win, Greg, they are right back in it.
And that's the fight this team has. They don't care what the odds are. They are going to keep battling. And suddenly, we got a series on our hands.
We sure do. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Kevin, thanks very much. Dwight, coming off of the loss in the last game, what was the difference tonight?
You know,
got a good win tonight coming from a tough game last night. We started out strong. We just stuck with it. We stayed together, and we got a good win.
And a good performance on the second night of a back-to-back. Thanks, Dwight. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And so this one is in the books. We hope you've enjoyed being with us for the Eastern Conference Finals. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. We'll see you next time. Have a great evening.